Welcome to the Course Paint Show. Let's have some fun today. Yeah, that's us right there. We're broadcasting from the gorgeous Vocal Media studio in Dallas. We got some great stories to tell about your gig last night, Minx. We drove to Austin on Friday. We also had a lot of fun in Dallas last night. So, man, join on board for some good rock metal stories from Texas. Right? So, yep. Minx, welcome back to the studio, man.
Thank you.
Yeah,
you look
welcome
good.
Back.
And so, last night, let's talk about your tribute band. It's the Thin White Dukes, right?
That thing is cutting out here. About the same time that Scary Cherry and the Bang Bangs got started, a friend of mine approached me about playing in a Bowie tribute band. Yeah. And I always kind of, was eh to tribute bands, but I actually got hired as a guitar player, and I thought, oh, that would be kind of a cool challenge to try and learn, like, all the guitar parts that, Mick Ronson did, Adrian Blue.
Right, all those great guitarists.
It was kind of a challenge at first, but then the singer quit. And
now you're a singer?
Yeah, so they... they were like, yeah, well, you want to sing now?
And yeah.
Right. It was kind of a switch, and we play,
Do you play Heroes?
Oh, yeah.
Of course.
Oh, yeah, yeah. We play deep cuts, too.
All right,
I mean,
good.
We play things that, only real Bowie fans would know. Other people do that their head goes, doink, like,
right.
What is that? But, We get into some deep shit, but
cool.
But we play the hits too.
Good gig last night.
It was great. I couldn't believe how many people came out. Surprisingly, for an outdoor show, because it was freezing.
And we're talking about at Lee Harvey's, which would only be in Dallas.
That's right.
Lee Harvey's,
one of the greatest dive bars in existence. And they proudly call themselves a dive bar.
Right.
But
what's
the backstory on that anyways? Was that actually, because it's a house. I was once told that it was a house that Lee Harvey lived in at one point. I don't know if I believe that, but.
Yeah. I don't know.
The Dallas rumor mill.
Janie Slash is here.
Hey.
Man, we love
having
beautiful. You on this show. Look at her.
Hey.
She is gorgeous.
Oh, thank
you. You lighten up this studio.
Thank you.
But speaking of studio, we got our basement, man.
It's
completely covered.
I love this place.
Every time
I walk in, it's like a horror film.
That's right.
Museum, gore. That's perfect. With the Gore magazine.
Yeah. Well, okay. Yeah. Speaking of Gore, now on Friday night, Janie Slash, and I told Ziggy we got to do this March on Science, but I think first we'll jump to. The slime wrestling photos, and she.
Oh my God!
Yeah, that's one right
Look
there.
Look at that.
We drove to Austin so I could slime wrestle for Gore Noir's Toxic Slime and Independence Brewery.
I just have to say that's hot.
Yeah, it is.
There were four rounds, eight girls, four rounds. I did not win the final thing, but I won my bout.
Whatever, that's so awesome! Yeah. I can't
Bikini
believe that.
Wrestling.
I wrestled.
Look at that. Look
her
at
name
that.
Was 11.
Her name was 11?
Yes, I wrestled 11.
You wrestled a cyborg.
Yes.
And won.
And won. She was tough, too.
Yeah.
Holy God.
Oh, yeah. She was great. Janie Slash was great. It was a fun at Independence Brewery in Austin.
Yeah.
And it was just, they had a couple of bands playing outdoors live.
Really?
And
cool.
then slime wrestling.
It had
so.
A really good turnout, too.
Yeah.
We
Isn't
missed the
Texas
big storm.
Awesome?
Yeah,
Isn't
Texas
it?
Is great.
Oh. Okay, so I wanted to throw out also some pictures of the March on Science, which was yesterday, and some of our favorite signs from the march that wound up on Hemet Mehta's email that he sends out, Pathos Friendly Atheist email. And so these are some photos from March on Science.
Oh, that's brilliant.
Yeah, I've seen smarter cabinets at IKEA.
But the directions are hard. Okay.
And without science, it's just fiction. The Gilligan's Island picture.
Oh, I saw that one.
Thank you, Ziggy. Yeah.
That's great.
Right. March on Science. So that was a big day yesterday for March on Science. So Way to go for all the participants there.
Absolutely. Yeah. I salute you with a slug of coffee.
Yes.
You went to the close by Starbucks. There's
yes,
one right
I did,
over there.
Of course, yeah.
It's perfect, man.
Well,
right?
It's right by my studio, yeah.
Hey, I've got
it's
a button for
Starbucks.
You. I want you to read this and wear it proudly.
What button is it? I don't even know what it is. What are you
it's pretty rude.
Really. Quit being rude.
Fuck witches, hail Satan.
your nice jacket there needs
it. Needs badly.
Needs some vulgarity.
Yeah.
You look too
it,
nice. So we need
looks,
to add
it
some
looks a
vulgarity.
Little pretty right now. Yeah.
Can't be too pretty. Yeah. Just kidding.
And can you hear me okay, Ziggy? I'm just, my headphones are, I don't know, maybe I didn't plug myself in.
You should make sure you're plugged. You are not plugged in. I said to check your... Yeah, he doesn't listen to me. He never listens to me.
Okay, that's better.
Is that better?
God.
Can you hear?
So while we were in Austin, Janie Slash was slime wrestling, and we decided it was international. It was Independent Record Store Day, but...
Well, day early.
It was
Friday.
Yeah.
The Record Store Day was Saturday, but we went to Waterloo.
Went to Waterloo, got me some Coliseum... Yeah,
I couldn't get him out of there. He was in there for like an hour. We were supposed to only stay for 20 minutes.
Year of the pig.
Waterloo, we got some arboreum, some early arboreum at
nice.
Waterloo. Waterloo in Austin.
It kicks ass, of course.
Yeah, it's amazing. It's hard to get. You can't be in there for 20 minutes. It's going to be an hour to an hour and a half. So I went into the horror section.
Look at this. I knew you'd like this one, Minx. It's The Horrors. It's a little EP.
Oh, yeah.
The Horrors.
This is fab. Wow.
And found Destruction, a double disc, Destruction. We love that.
That is beautiful. Wow, what a great cover, too.
But then we spent some time at...
look at the haircuts.
That's Bowie, isn't it, right?
That is awesome.
of course, we support our local independent record store, Born Late, in Fort Worth, Texas, on Race Street.
Right.
And picked up some great stuff there, too. Of course, seeing our friend John Perez, and then Hint of Death. Got to have those guys
in
the studio.
They did 20% off everything in the whole store all weekend.
Did
they
really?
Own kind of special things.
Oh,
yeah,
man, I missed out.
T-shirts, CDs, Texas albums, metal. Cassette tapes, DVDs, everything in the store is 20% off.
Yeah.
Wow,
so take
great.
A look at this one, too, man. That's some Texas death metal from a few years back, you know, when extreme metal was just kind of blossoming in Texas, so
love
we support
it.
This band too. I ordered a CD, they sent it to me right away. I mean, I ordered a T-shirt, they sent it to me right away, and we love the CD too. So that's
you're wearing the shirt.
Epic Death.
Epic Death.
Local band.
They were corpse.
Black
band.
Metal corpse paint band.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
You would
they're brilliant. Yeah,
playing some great symphonic. Black metal and some straightforward black metal. I like them.
Yeah.
They do an Alice Cooper cover.
Do they really?
Yeah,
they
Poison.
Oh, no kidding.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. So that was fun checking out all the record stores, which we did Friday and Saturday.
Do they?
Of course.
Yeah.
They deliver the goods.
I think that's what we're listening to right now.
Very interesting.
Ziggy, if you want to jump it to. Track 6 on that CD?
Yeah, all right. Let's hear it. That's brilliant.
Yeah, is Poison. And they do a rocked out version of it, which I like a lot. So, hail to those guys.
The event
Friday, sponsored by this magazine.
Gore.
It was their event.
Gore Noir. Gore Noir.
This one's a scratch and sniff issue. I recommend not scratching and sniffing. I can
you
still
like that
smell
mix?
It.
That sounds good.
Yeah.
Wow, nice.
That's a nice sound, isn't it?
That's a great cover.
This is a Texas magazine. Gore Noir. Get over here. A little evil, isn't it?
Oh, that's great.
Yeah. Sounds like when you first heard Judas Priest, you're like, evil. Yeah.
Yeah, they got the good. That is awesome.
Anyways, yeah.
Anything that scares me is good. You know? I like when this music haircuts, actually gives me a chill. You
these,
know?
Hair, these haircuts
That's
scared.
That's how it should be.
Can you see them, Janie?
I can see those. Those are very interesting.
They scare
me. Those are some very intense bangs.
Yeah, that's serious bangs.
Serious bangs. I'm from the generation of the wispy bangs.
Hey, so guess who we're calling in 5 minutes?
Could I make a guess on that?
Make a guess, yeah.
I would guess Calico Cooper.
Yeah, well, that's a good guess, man.
Yeah. So,
Calico's band is called Beasto Blanco. What a great band.
Brilliant.
Yeah, so they got two CDs out now. And a couple weeks back, we had Brother Latham on the show
He was super nice.
From Beasto Blanco.
Great interview.
Brother Latham, one of the guitarists in the band. And a great, great guest he was on the show.
We're
lucky enough now to have Calico Cooper. And, you know, rumor has it that there's another big rock star currently on tour with Deep Purple that goes, that guy goes by Calico's dad as his
Alice.
Kind of his title, yeah.
Actually, you know, Calico's he's dad. Playing next week. Or is it next week? It's May 6th in Oklahoma.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
With Deep Purple?
I'm going. Yeah. No. This is without the Deep Purple.
Okay.
This is just his tour.
All right, yeah.
Awesome.
I mean, you know, I wouldn't mind seeing him with Deep Purple. You know,
Let's cut to something. We were at Vampire Endless Nights last night.
Yeah.
So the fun continues in Dallas, Texas. If you're in Texas, you're going to be exposed to a lot of great events and music.
Yeah, we went to go see Scarlet Divine.
So this
perform.
Is why we could not go to your gig. I'm sorry.
No, perfect.
We wanted to.
Yeah, I wanted to be there.
No, come on. That is the wonder of Scarlet Divine on Silks at the Church,
she
also
did
known
a
as Lizard Lounge.
10-minute long ambient set.
She did. It's actually got 12.
Okay, 12 minutes. She said she told me 10.
This is our friend Dan Sperry, who has been on this show. A great magician, and
he's super talented.
And he did a on-stage performance last night that was just
outstanding. He's a friendly dude too. He hung around.
Really?
You could talk to
him.
Yeah, he was always like on the smoking patio or at his merch table. He's always easy to find.
So heck yeah, hails to. And then of course we saw them,
Gorehounds. Yeah.
And talking
about
tribute bands.
All of Avera's chain performance. She was doing ambient chains, and it was incredible. I almost missed it. I walked out, and there she is hanging from these two chains.
Yeah,
right. A lot of people that went to the Thin White Duke show last night went to our first set, and then they left and went to Endless Night.
Oh, well, cool.
Yeah, you know, we were like, go for it, you know. But, I wish I could have done that, too.
So the
one set and go.
The vampire scene in Dallas is fun, and they have events like Endless Nights with all that entertainment you just saw.
Church.
So
I'm just an old vampire. That's
No.
All the vampires were out last night. So.
You're a young man. You're a young vampire. So that was great fun, too, at Lizard Lounge / The Church, Dallas, Texas, Deep Ellum.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, man. I mean, what a great fun weekend we've had. We picked up this movie, too, which we'll talk about a little bit. Instead of Death Rock, it's Death...
Death Rot.
Rot.
Death Rot.
Death Rot.
Yeah, it's okay.
No, but it's kind of like...
No. Watch Motel Hell instead.
It's kind of like... Or Deathgasm.
No, it's not like Deathgasm. It looks like Deathgasm.
This is a
like
badass
Deathgasm.
Metal band. Their bus breaks down in
their
the middle of...
Their bus breaks down
in the middle of a creepy...
Cannibals and all that stuff.
Yeah, a creepy kind of farm
area. You weren't thrilled?
No, not really.
I loved it!
You love everything.
Death Rot! How could you
if
not
if it's got
like
blood in it, he's happy.
You
is that the deal?
You can watch it on Amazon Prime for free if you're interested.
Oh, well then I shall
so
do
no
that
harm, no
tonight.
Harm. Yeah.
Death Rot.
Death Rot.
So you see that post for Deathgasm over there.
It needed a little more editing. That was my main complaint.
Yeah.
It's almost 2 hours long. It's like an hour and 41 minutes.
Yeah.
I haven't seen Deathgasm.
Deathgasm's great.
Yeah, all right.
And so is,
So
the other horror, the other metal movie. What is it called?
Okay, but, well, hold on. This is a genre of horror,
mm-hmm.
which is metal band horror films. There seems to be a little subgenre developing.
Fabulous.
Yeah.
I'm glad to hear that.
There is a great short called Death Metal. Is that right?
Yeah.
Death Metal.
Yeah.
That we'll be showing at Frightmare Weekend at midnight on Friday, and it's fucking awesome. It's way better than Death Rock.
Let's get Calico on the phone.
Yeah, let's do it.
Let's do it.
Of course. Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Good, good.
Hello? Hello? We're trying to get Calico on the phone. I think she...
One ringy dingy.
I think she's in the car. I think she's like talking to us from her car, which is cool.
That is great.
We love Beasto Blanco. Hello there.
These don't work.
They don't? So when Amanda gets here...
I'll give her mine. Mm.
Yeah, okay, all right.
Yeah, mine. I've been checking.
Okay, yeah, just, yeah, just when she can. Look at you, Mario. Yeah, good. Hello, hello, Calico? Hello, hello. We'll try and connect with her. We're reaching out on Skype, and I know that she is, I think, mobile. I think she's in her car, so we'll try again. But, and then later on this show, we're talking to Leaves Eyes, mm-hmm. is the band.
Oh, great.
And her name is Elina.
Yeah.
The
We have her.
Yeah.
Hello. Hi.
Hello.
Hi, Calico.
Hi, Calico. Welcome to the Corpse Paint Show.
We want to make sure we can hear you. Can you hear Ziggy?
I can't hear.
We're having trouble hearing you. We can see you fine.
Love the hat.
See? For some reason, yeah, there's no audio coming from your end. Okay. Take your time.
Okay.
Now we get to study. Iggy Pop. Iggy Pop just turned 70.
I do.
All hails to Iggy.
I do agree. I love her hat.
Yeah. Oh no, it's brilliant.
Yeah, it's an adorable hat.
I know you're a huge Iggy fan.
Love the man.
And you know he just celebrated a birthday.
Yes.
One of those big zero birthdays. Mm-hmm. And okay, so we'll try and get audio going. So. Okay. Hi, Calico. All right, this is the part of the show where we teach you sign language. No, I'm kidding.
Experiencing technical difficulties here.
We'll get it rolling. We'll get it rolling.
Oh, I heard something. I heard a click.
That almost did it, I think. No, we cannot hear you yet.
It's closer. I heard something.
We should try to reconnect.
Should we dial in a second time, maybe? No?
No?
Okay. Oh, there we go.
Oh, there we go.
All right.
Yes,
Calico,
we can hear you.
We just want to tell you we love Beasto Blanco.
Well, thank you, man. Thank you so much. It's so much fun to do. What a character.
Yes, and it looks like you have a lot of fun on stage, and you're surrounded by these great musicians, and all you guys are just, and I think I told Kara this, I think of you guys as energetic and full of just vigor and life and fitness, and you just portray that to me. You really do. A lot of vitality. I guess that's the word I'm looking for.
Fitness.
Yeah, it's a good word. We definitely are, we're part ghouls, part cavemen, I don't even know how that came together, but I think it's sort of like our dynamic together. I mean, it is like a bunch of like ghoulish cavemen. That's the best way that I can describe it.
Part workout video.
Right. And yeah, it's very, very energetic.
I say that all the time, and I'm telling you this. I said, if you give any woman a bat and high heels and have her jump around like that for an hour, you will be in the best shape of your life.
There you go.
Intense.
Yes. Yeah. Well, Janie Slash is here, and she herself is a sideshow performer, and I awesome. Think she can attest to that, too. So
Yeah,
and you know, there's like people go, what do you do for exercise? I'm like, well, I have this bat.
And I have this band.
And this band, and they let me chase them around and headbang. And headbanging really does burn a lot of calories.
It absolutely does. What have we mentioned before here, Janie? And that is MoshFit.
Yes.
There's a
workout program called MoshFit. They took that whole concept and turned it into it. Yeah.
So if you're in a mosh pit, you're getting fit. And so he started this, like, for gyms. He was doing this promotion for a thing called Mosh Fit.
That's amazing. They do it at bars, actually.
I had no idea.
It's done
that's
at bars.
Hilarious.
Oh, at bars. After the class, they drink.
Okay.
You actually have a chance of getting me at the gym, if that's a real thing.
Yeah.
I would go Mosh Fit.
It's popular in New York. It's a New York thing right now. It needs to expand. I think that would be one of the most popular workout programs.
I think you should start that here.
Okay.
Yes. That would be amazing.
Calico,
I am your Mosh Fit instructor!
Yeah!
Exactly.
And now we're going to put on some... some Cannibal Corpse.
Go!
It also would be great for aggression. I'm just saying.
Yeah.
You would leave feeling great.
Get it all in once. Therapy, get your body worked out, just like one-stop shop.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I think the bat must help with aggression. There
you go.
Yeah, I don't know if you would let them have bats in Mosh Fit.
This is what I say time and again. It's therapeutic. Metal is therapeutic. Because
amen, brother.
Yes. Hey, we had a great time with Brother Latham, and he was really nice and a great guest. And, you know, just a big high five to him. So give him a hug when you see him next. And Calico, hey, we were in Phoenix a year ago, and we ate at a great place called Cooperstown.
Isn't that, you know what's crazy is I had to work there when I was in high school. It's
really
humiliating. It's
no, it can't.
No.
No, because, well, no, the restaurant's great, the food's great, the staff's great, everything's great, but to have to wear his makeup, have to wear my dad's makeup and be like, would you like smoking or non-smoking? Like, I mean, I've had real jobs, I've definitely had my share, I've been, you know, waitress, a barista, I've sold jeans, like, I wanted to you know, have a full experience in life, and also, you know, I'm pretty passionate about being able to pay my bills.
Yeah,
of course.
So in high school, my parents were like, you need a job. And I was like, well, I'll work at the restaurant. And it was a great environment. But the people that would recognize me are like, didn't I see you on stage? I'm like, nope.
cover up your name tag there.
Hi, I'm Kelly.
I'm Kelly. And my last name is Cooperstein.
Cooperstein, yeah.
Hey,
I like Cooperstein. That's good, yeah.
There's two great videos we are enjoying the heck out of right now, and that's, of course, Feed My Frankenstein, but what's the other one called? The Grind.
Oh, yeah, that's
Grind.
Brilliant.
Yeah.
Grind is really, really fun. That's the first time I ever worked with a drone, and it is a bit jarring. Like, you know, you're standing there in the desert, and all of a sudden this, like, Terminator 2, like, thing just, like, comes right in your face, and you have to just kind of, like, look past it, like, you're cool with it, but it drops out of nowhere, and you're just like, hey. Try to stay looking metal, but it's pretty shocking.
Oh, that's funny. Hey, so you are mainly based in Phoenix, right?
No, I've lived in L.A. for almost 15, 16 years.
Oh,
okay.
Wow.
Okay, all right. Okay. I didn't know if you ever got back to Phoenix. We're going to the event called Mad Monster next month.
My buddies all go to, like, Doyle and Ace Von Johnson and all those guys, Wednesday 13,
Yeah,
well,
we
that's
saw Doyle
cool.
there last year.
We love Doyle. We love Wednesday. And you know who was there last year, a special guest? Was it Peter Chris?
No. No, that was Frightmare.
No, one of the guys from Kiss. Maybe I'm thinking of the year before.
That was Frightmare.
But anyways, man, if you ever get out to that, we're gonna get in tickets and get in line and get your autograph, too.
Awesome. You know what's crazy is I've been to a couple of those, like when my dad's done them. What an event! Like Monster Palooza. I mean,
awesome.
I am like a kid in a candy store. Where do you look that something not cool is?
Monster Palooza is amazing too. The makeup and the special effects—it's incredible.
Yes,
so cool.
Yeah,
and I mean, you can't really see because I'm cleaning it up, but I collect D and C rated horror movies. I have over let's see if I can kind of where do you go with this? But there's just that's one. But on the other side of the computer is just rows and rows and rows. I have over like 2,000 terrible horror movies.
That's awesome.
Hey,
terrible horror movies. We've had a whole
Calico,
tablet of them.
Can I show you a terrible one we just picked up in Austin? And
yes?
I'm gonna hold this up. It's called Death Rot.
Death Rot. Oh my gosh.
Does that look crazy?
Amazing.
And guess what? It's about this band that's traveling through. It looks like it's in your video for Grind. They're traveling through the desert, and their bus breaks down, of course, in an area where there's no Wi-Fi, of course. And
oh, so, no!
Yeah. And
then cell service.
And there's a crazy person nearby, of course.
Of course.
And I just love it. And they're cannibals. They happen to be cannibals.
Of course. Well, I mean, come on. What is a terrible horror movie without cannibals?
Exactly.
I thought you were going to grab something that I had been in, because I have been in a couple of turkeys.
Well, no. Suck is not a turkey.
Yeah.
No, that's a really good movie, right?
That's a good movie. Oh, one of my favorite Canadian films.
It is. It's one of his favorite movies.
I really wished your part would have been bigger. I know it's a little, just a bit part, but I really like the movie. I like you in it. I like your dad in it. I like the whole film. Iggy Pop's in it.
Oh, yeah.
Iggy Pop is also in it. And you know what's funny is it was really hard to get in that movie. And you know the whole thing about nepotism in the movie business. It's not true, because I literally had my last line of defense is trying to use that. Being like, hey, listen, if it's not good enough, usually it's not good enough. But I really wanted to be in this movie because obviously the cast is amazing and the story is awesome. And, so it was like a double-edged sword because I was trying to get in. And, you know, Canada has their own union, actors union.
Yes.
So basically I had to prove that I was the only one that could do this job. Why can't they get a Canadian actress that lives there to do it?
Oh, yeah. They're...
I literally the only thing that they cared about was they were like, oh, well, it's kitschy because it's actually Alice's daughter. And they were like, well, okay.
But Janie / knows I just played the heck out of that movie, I think, for a year straight.
I bought it for you.
And, really?
I bought it for him. I told him he had to own his favorite movie because he would talk about it all the time and I hadn't seen it. So I went and bought it for him. I was like, you have to have your favorite movie. It's weird to not own it.
Okay. So,
he showed it to me.
Calico, you know who I like in that movie too is Dimitri Coates.
Oh yeah,
isn't he cool?
Isn't he?
Super.
That
awesome.
Guy is way cool.
He is way cool, and I remember seeing him, and I was familiar with the band, but I so striking, and I walked in on him in full costume. So he was, the red hair and the big, green blue eyes.
Yeah.
And I was like, hey, and he turned around, and he was like, all crazy looking. I was like, whoa, Jay.
and I bet he didn't even tease his hair. It just normally sticks out like that, his hair.
It does. It does. He just looks like, he's one of those...
gets out of bed that way.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's just one of those, # woke up like this. Like,
and then he his band Off, I know he was in Burning Brides, and I love them, but then Off...
I love that band, yeah.
I love them. And then Off played Dallas not too long ago, and I was lucky enough to get a picture with him. We've seen Off a few times.
I love Off. Yeah.
I love Off.
He's great on stage, great too. Man. He's like Calico on stage. It's like pure energy.
You know what? I will not attribute it to any brand of energy drink, but that certainly doesn't hurt.
Okay.
I think you got some good genes going there.
Yeah. Okay. People sometimes ask me, they're like, well, because the first Beasto record, I did a lot of this sort of character voice, and the voice was like, I started off by, I was kind of making fun of Chuck, because he's one of my oldest friends, and he does this really specific voice, and so I would follow him around, and I would sing, like, standards, like, why do birds suddenly, but I would do it, like, in the Chuck voice.
Right.
And he goes, you can sing like that?
Yeah.
And I go, oh, no, I'm just copying you. And he goes, but you can do it, like, on command. And I said, yeah. So he goes, I have this idea. You should come in and do a couple songs on my record. At the time, it was, like, he and Chris, Brother Latham, had this band.
Right.
So I came in to do it, and it sounded awesome. Our voices just worked really well together. And so for that whole first Beasto record, all I did was this, like, screechy kind of, like, cartoon voice. And then we came in to do Frankenstein, the cover of Frankenstein.
Right.
And I was, again, joking around. This seems to be like a running theme, but I was joking around and I was doing it in like this smoky lounge singer kind of voice. And Chuck goes, wait a minute, you can sing like that? And I go, you never asked me. You just told me to growl. And I go, I can do that. So I love the way Frankenstein came out. It's just like a whole other type of singing, but it's easier to do that than it is to do that, the Beasto voice. So I call it Beasto voice is... It's an arena voice. It's hard to keep up for an hour and a half.
That's for when you're performing in front of 30,000 people.
Yeah. It's got to carry to the back. But we just did a tour in Germany where it was like, it's amazing. It was 20,000 people every night. Like, we're playing with this band, The Uncles, and I just sound checking, you know, I'd put my little in-ears in, and they'd have everybody go, okay, Jan, Chuck, everybody, and they go Calico, and the first day at sound check, I was like, you might want to turn your ears down.
Turn your ears down.
And the guy goes, I think it's going to be all right. He's like, what are you, 115 pounds soaking wet? I was like, you might want to turn those down a little bit.
And so did you blow them away?
Yeah. I said, you want me to get as loud as I'm going to? Because in the show, you know, you get adrenaline going and you get really loud. And so I said, okay, I'm going to do it. And Chuck's looking at me like, my God. He asked me.
Yeah.
So and I just hauled off and gave him a big, like, you know, yell. And they were like, whoa.
120 decibels of hell.
If you set back a German metal sound guy, I got to hand it to you.
I want a diploma or something that says that I blew out a German sound guy's ears.
Yeah. And you know what? I was talking to Kara about Bose Uncles, if I'm pronouncing it right. I like that band a lot. I think it's badass that you toured with them.
I know. It was really crazy. Like, you know,
what a cool band.
We put on the same show, whether we are playing for 500 people at the Whiskey or we're playing for 20,000 people. And I just, that was really comforting because, like, you know, you get on stage and you never really know, like, is an arena I'm going to react to Beasto. And it just turns out that we turn up, you know, I just use a kid rap term, turn up. I turned up. we just rise, kind of grows to the occasion. And then I realized, did we really, or am I just having more space to run? Like, I have the same amount of energy, no matter what we do.
But you got to
just as crazy.
You got to cover that space though.
You got a bigger stage in Germany when there's 20,000 people.
Well, and then they made the mistake of giving me ego risers, which was hysterical because I can't stay off of them. So the show starts and I'm like, woo, 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 just. Yeah. And by the end of it, I'm going, oh my gosh, like I'm going to drop dead of a coronary.
Hey, Calico, we have two people in the studio that play in a tribute band called Dallas Cooper.
Nice.
Isn't that great?
That's awesome.
So we've got Minx to my left, and he plays guitar and sings Alice, and we got Amanda here, who actually kind of does your role on some of the old Alice songs on stage. They do a huge production.
Your choreography, for that matter.
That's awesome. Yeah. So which parts do you do? What stuff do you do?
I do the only women bleed, and when you're the doll version.
Right.
Yeah.
I chose that one over the other version. Was that you dancing the other version in the? It was more contemporary movement.
Yeah. That was my mom is more ballet. She's doing it now. When I was doing it, it was that contemporary dance was like really like a thing. And I go, well, it used to be ballet. Let's make it current. And at the time, contemporary dance was current.
And
so.
I loved it. My body at over 40 can't keep up with that. So I went.
My body at 19 was like, why are you doing this?
So we went for the other version of it. And then we do the nurse.
Right.
Oh, great. Yeah.
But the nurse version, it's a lot closer to her. It's a little more.
To yours,
It's a little more radical.
Yeah. You know, it's what's great about anybody that takes that role on is it really does have sort of a, you bring a little bit of yourself into it. And I was always a little more like, my mom is very like regal. You know, she has a very regal quality about her on and off stage.
She does.
I mean, she's gnarly, and a great actress, but she does it this really regal sort of sensual. And I mean, it all ties in with the Beasto thing. Like, I'm just an animal.
Yeah.
So, you know what I mean? And so when I started doing the nurse, that was way before Beasto, you know, when my dad told me to really make it my own, I just kind of, this woman was not, she wasn't graceful. And she was, I always played her like she was crazier than Alice. That was just a choice that I made.
Neat.
You know what I mean? To make it interesting.
It shows, too.
Make him the good guy and I'm the bad guy.
Right, exactly.
Being a villain's villain is a lot of fun, and you can really mess with it, and you can go super far. But then now whenever I go back just to play around, you know, I'm going to go actually visit in a couple weeks. I let my mom do what she does best, which is just have this, like, command of the stage, this, like, super regal presence, and then I just turn into, like, a hellhound. I put this like burned cross on my head and I got one eye with a patch on it.
Love it. See, we all have all the world's a stage. We are merely the players. And when you're on stage, sometimes you're another self, and maybe that is your true self.
And, hey, look, that must live somewhere inside of me. It must. Because it consistently comes out. So.
Well, that's cool.
Hey, let's play 6 degrees of separation here for a moment. So the lead singer from my original band, Scary Cherry and the Bang Bangs.
Awesome.
She was Tracy in Nightmare on Elm Street, Freddy's Dead, The Final Nightmare. So she,
really?
Your father was her father. In the film, yeah.
No kidding. Yeah. Oh, cool.
Oh, yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah, so that was...
That is so rad. Yeah, I love that whole... you know, they came out with those anthologies where it was like...
Uh-huh.
They covered, you know, the entire world of Nightmare on Elm Street. They did it for Friday the 13th, too.
Right.
And I sat for 2 days straight on my couch just being like... it's so amazing. So entertaining. Yeah.
So next time you're in Dallas, okay, we want you to come by this studio because you would love all the movies we have here, okay? All the some not so good horror films, but also
I want the good ones.
But right,
anybody can see the good ones.
But let everyone else see those. But yes, but also we'll have to coordinate it with a Dallas Cooper show at one of the venues here in town.
I would happily come see a Dallas Cooper show. Let me ask you guys a question.
Yeah.
What is your favorite bit to kind of do to play?
You know, I gotta say, well, first of all, when I took that on, you know, because I'm really a guitar player, you know, for an original band. But when I took it on, I was asked to do it, and they bugged me for 2 years to do it. So I finally said, okay, I'm gonna do this. It is so hard. Oh my God! I mean, we do the full show.
Yeah.
You know, like we can run up to 2 hours, no problem. You know. So,
really?
Yeah.
That's hard, no matter what you're doing. It's a two-hour show is a two-hour show. But then add theatrics add committing to those theatrics. It's definitely not easy.
Yeah. I really love Dwight Fry. And, I mean, it's my favorite part of the show. And we don't do the hanging. We do the guillotine. We have, you know, a 10-foot-6, you know, guillotine. Actual operating the real built to the same specs that you know was used in the
That's
real
super shows. Cool. Yeah. The one that was the most dangerous, and this is hysterical because it seems the most innocuous, was on a I can't remember what tour it was. I think it might have been theater. No, it was before Theater of Death, but it was called The Recuperator, and it was this. Machine. Oh, it's Brutal Planet. There was this machine, this like Frankenstein machine, and I would go around and pick up the body parts.
The one where you almost fall in there, yourself.
And then I would put his head in, shut it, and pull the thing, and it would explode, and you know whatever. And I consistently got more stitches from that stupid piece of crap machine because the thing is that these things are not necessarily meant to travel. I mean, we do like this big Broadway type show, and generally those shows land for, you know, a couple months at a time. But these crew guys are like superhuman, moving these 2,000-3,000-pound pieces of magic equipment.
Yes,
you know, on and off the truck. But this thing got so busted up that at one point it was literally the front. It looked all badass, right? It was like these broken light bulbs. They weren't supposed to be broken, but they were. So like broken light bulbs and like shattered glass, and it just looked really gnarly, and you know, everybody's always like running into it, cutting themselves. But on the back it was held together with duct tape in the back. Because we did it. Who's gonna fix it? Will you call your local like Frankenstein machine fix guy?
Right.
Who do you call?
You got on tour.
So held with duct tape and a broomstick. Held it in place in the back, and we joked around. We wrote on it, Acme Coffin Stop.
Right. Isn't that funny? But I want Amanda to have a chance to answer that question, too. Maybe your favorite on stage with Dallas Cooper.
Oh, it's definitely the nurse.
Okay.
Absolutely. Yeah. Well, when Mario asked me, I'm embarrassed to say I didn't know a lot of Alice Cooper material. I mean, I knew his music, obviously. So when he said, do you want to do this, you know, rock and roll bit, I thought, oh, I don't know. Do I want to be some chick in a rock and roll band in the back, you know? And
right.
So,
but it's totally not that, right?
Totally
it
not
seems,
that.
It seems like, you know, you don't want to be like, you know, I'm on a box and dancing in my bikini. But, like, that character is, like,
no, it was rehearsed.
Kind of show.
I studied and studied and studied that material. I actually sent you copies of it via Facebook.
We're not friends on Facebook.
I was that proud of it because it was really important for me to do it justice because I felt like the two of you coming from a professional dance background that I needed to do it justice. I wanted to do it justice, you know. And I wanted to be myself but enhanced by the two of you also. It's difficult to do a part that only a handful of people have done. You know.
Right, you totally like have, you know, carte blanche to like do, like there's something about you that I could never play, you know what I mean? And that's going to be something that's going to make you memorable, you know, in that show is like, oh, that girl is so good. And you don't know why,
yeah.
But, you know, she's got that thing.
Well, what I hear you saying is you're saying to Amanda, make it your own from Calico Cooper, make it your own.
No, well, yeah, I'm thrilled. Yeah, no, it's
I do. I took what my mom did and of the stuff I liked, and I would kind of stay to that material. But then, you know, there's just things that make me different. You know what I mean? Like we were talking about just kind of being like snapping into whatever weird like werewolf mindset that I get into. But I would love to see.
Great.
You do that. I would love to see that.
Yeah. I like doing Only Women Bleed too, but you know she's so much prettier. You know, and it's clean lines and soft, and I mean, you know, she's killed at the end. I'd rather come out and be.
Well, that's why
vicious.
I didn't try to do it like that because I'm not I'm not like graceful in that way. Could I play it that way? Sure, but I mean, I think that like it just made more sense for me to be a little more raw, and the movement was more raw, and like the emotion was more raw, just because. That's kind of my wheelhouse.
Yeah,
you know I
loved it. I would just have to pack my body in ice the next day. So we opted for a little bit more the other variety version.
But I'm sure
it,
you guys all know, like, you know, you're excited about being on stage, whatever. You can do superhuman things, and then the next day you're like, why?
Yes. Janie Slash pounds like big spikes into her head. This is part of her on stage.
Human blockhead. No.
Human blockhead. So, yay!
That's amazing. You really do?
Yeah.
Wow!
Yeah, I do that. And also, I lay on beds and nails while he smashes cinder blocks off of me. And then it feels great that day. And the next day, I'm like, what did I do?
Yeah, this was insanity.
Yes.
I did that
That's
once.
Really
I was
cool.
trying
the power of adrenaline.
Put together an IKEA
The power of adrenaline.
Bottle. Well, I think they call that meth. I was going to say, I wish I could bottle the power of adrenaline, but I think that's crack.
Yeah, we better not, right?
I think it is.
I'm going to do that.
Calico, we'd love to have you in the studio if you're ever future in Dallas or could, you know, see a Dallas Cooper show. Wouldn't that be cool? God.
I'd rather
love
see a Beasto
come
Blanco
down.
Show.
Yeah.
Yeah, and we want to see Beasto Blanco,
yeah,
of course.
See Beasto Blanco.
Heck yeah, man. We'll be in those parts. I think we're doing a new record right now, so I think probably by the end of the year we'll probably be in the ticks there.
Well, good. Awesome. Okay, let me stay in touch with Kara, please. And just a shout out to Kara, your assistant, and she handles.
She is
oh
fantastic.
My gosh,
she is so nice,
isn't she?
Yes, she's the sweetest.
Please give her a big hug from the Corpse Paint Show team. I mean, just really great to work with, and so nice.
Awesome.
All right, so
great.
I you know really really appreciate your time, Calico.
Yeah,
we
you.
Do. And, man, I think of you every time I go to Phoenix, and we're going to be there next month, and we're going to try and eat at Cooperstown again.
We will
again.
Be at Cooperstown. Yeah, it's the first place we're going.
Did you get the big unit?
No, I need to.
You got to. You got it just to be like, yeah, girl, I had the big unit.
I'll get the big unit next time I go. I forgot. I love the like all the awesome names of all the food.
I'm
it's so hard
to
order.
That is now.
It's a 3-foot-long hot dog.
It's a hot dog.
Oh,
the unit.
Hot dog.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's 3 feet long, and then they also have this the catcher's mitt. It's this huge brownie, like the size of my head, and it's incredible. And it's shaped like a baseball mitt.
Yeah.
But it's
I had the mac and cheese. I think it was like the I don't remember what song it was. I don't.
Oh, remember. You know what they named after me? So they have everybody, all three kids, all of my parents.
Yeah.
Three of us. We all have something on the menu. So it's like. Sonoran fries and like it's like the dash meatloaf or whatever it is like and it's like I'm looking through the menu going well where's my thing they gave me the baked beans Calico baked beans.
Calico baked beans. Yeah.
It's on. It's on.
It's you on watch. Now. Yeah. Well, that's I do want to say we had great service there.
Oh, I bought a t-shirt.
We bought a t-shirt. Yeah. The staff was very nice.
Had
and
a beer.
And
it was great. We were there yes, for a while.
We had a great,
it's
great
such
time.
Such crazy good bar, right?
It yeah. is. And it's a mini museum. If you're a Cooper fan, get in
there. I remember
there.
Going to the bathroom and being like, the bathroom is incredible, but you can't go in there because you're a man.
Sorry. And then you're that creepy girl, like, cell phone videoing everything in the bathroom.
Yeah, taking selfies. Like, hold on. Wait yeah. 1 second.
Yeah, right, right, right.
Girl.
Yeah. Now I want to hear about the bathroom.
Oh, that was fun. And, well, hey, and you got married last year. A big congrats on that.
Thank you so much. He's still alive, by the way.
Woo!
He made it.
He's still alive.
We salute him.
There was side bets going on. Like, how long will she let him bloom? We don't right. know.
How long? And, yeah, he's got to have some stamina to keep up with Calico.
Yeah, well, I mean, he certainly knows how to fix a computer microphone, so we'll keep him around. Nice.
Calico, man, thanks a bunch.
No, thank you.
Totally. Thanks for having me.
What else? You guys want to say a salute to Calico? We really appreciate your time today.
Oh my gosh, absolutely. I drove through Coachella traffic for you.
That's thank you.
My
yeah,
God.
That's a nightmare yeah. in itself.
Yeah, I've been there, done that, and yeah.
Dude, there was a wedding up there that I was at this weekend, and of course, right through Coachella, and we were like, it was like driving away from the T-Rex in Jurassic Park. We were like, go faster, must go faster.
Well, wait a second. Was the wedding at Coachella, or...
Wedding was in the middle of the desert at this place called The Ruin, and it's this old prospector's house that burned down. Oh, and wow. So they're all that's left are like some of the walls and the fireplace, and like it's out in the middle of nowhere. It's super creepy, but this great couple got married there, not knowing a year in advance that Coachella was then, and then they were like, sorry.
Oh, the oh. same weekend. No kidding. Oh, boy. What else? What else, Amanda? What else, Janie Slash?
I still love her hat. I'm yeah. just saying.
Thank you. Well, I do have to tell you one thing. If you ever do the part where that we did in Theater of Death, where he rips off all of your nurse stuff and puts it on himself, there's a trick to okay. that wig coming off because
okay.
my friend who plays, I just met her. Everybody's my friend. She plays the nurse in another Alice tribute band, and she goes, I've been dying to meet you for 5 years to ask you this question.
Yeah.
How do you keep the wig on your head so that he can rip it off and it doesn't take your hair, but it also stays on your head?
Gotcha.
And I'm telling her how to do it, and I don't realize that there's a family behind me,
oh.
and I'm going, well... When my dad rips my hair out, and I go, and when he rips the dress off, you got to be really careful because it's too small for him.
Oh,
so,
oh this
and
is
then
so
behind
funny.
He's going,
oh my god! Really? That's
what
awesome.
Is holding the wig on the wig clip?
So yeah, this is the trick. Normally, you would anchor that thing to your head.
Yeah.
Because the nurse in my mind, whenever I started playing her, she was always a redhead. I don't know why she just was, and. And so I had this red wig on, and, you know, he would push me down, right? He would grab the nurse's outfit and rip that off, and he'd go to grab the wig. And the first couple of shows, he took chunks of my hair because I pinned it. So we worked it out. You know those little monster clips?
Yes.
They're like the alligator ones? So you lift up half the wig, monster clip it on, and then throw the wig hair back. So when he reaches to grab, it looks like he's grabbing the back of your head, but he's just taking the clip out, and the whole wig comes off.
Oh, I gotcha. See, right. Ah,
that's really job. Smart. I like that.
I went to college.
I had to practice that costume change between Women Only Bleed and her entrance. I mean, because it's like 45 seconds to a minute, and I probably rehearsed that more than the actual choreography.
I know.
The
I
changing
know.
Of the wigs, the makeup, and everything, yeah.
That is, and people underestimate how hard. Like, do you think I just, like, apparate in this costume? This is right. hard to do.
Yeah, it's been thrilling to perform it. I hope that we, or at least I, am doing it justice.
You are.
Will you do me a favor and reset, because I have so many back messages. I really want to see it. Will you resend it to me?
I'll resend it to you, but it's, you know, we're not friends on Facebook, so you might have to go into that
other folder.
Other folder.
The scary folder.
Okay, yeah, you know, I'm so rubbish at Facebook. I didn't realize that you can only have so many, like, people.
Yeah.
And I was like, but I don't know any of these people. So I tried in vain to go through and be like, okay, I don't know you. So I just started a whole, fan page, and then I can actually, like, see people and talk to them. And
I feel like this one is, like, a personal page of you. It's a black and white shot. Your hair is, like, chin length. So I think
that's the one that got overrun to the point where I'm just like, I don't even know. But there's a one where I'm in a white dress and I'm able to get messages on.
Okay, I'll try sending it there.
Cool.
Okay, and then we can talk to you there at the fan page.
Yeah. I get those messages. I got slapped on the wrist enough from people that they were like, really? You can't look? And I go, look, there's 500 messages.
Sure, yeah.
It's not because of me. It'd be like one thing if I was like a huge douche and I was like, oh yeah, all these people are writing me.
Well,
sometimes they need stuff, and I'm so empathetic. Like, a lot of people are in financial need, or they're in like health issues, and people need a lot of things, and I feel bad if I can't help them.
Yes.
Because you can't help, you know, everybody, and I don't know why you're asking me, but I do my best if I can.
Sure, sure.
But then some people get really mean about it, really aggro, and you're like, I can't believe that you couldn't give me, you know, 10 tickets to this or that. I'm going, dude, like, come on, man. What are you doing?
I got an electric bill that needs to be paid.
Yes.
Yeah.
Well,
I mean, you'd be surprised what I get. You'd be surprised.
Calico, so can we have her say from Amanda from the Corpse Paint Show or something like that?
I usually recognize the word corpse paint. Like, I would open up an email that said corpse paint.
Can we officially consider you a friend of the Corpse Paint Show?
Oh yeah, I'm in the family now.
we're glad to be part of your family, and I'm sitting next to Minx, and I feel like I've got your father right next to me here. He is the singer in that band, and it's cool.
Yeah. Awesome. I cannot wait to see it.
Woo!
Oh, thank you.
All right. Well, Amanda's going to send that. Thank you for your time. Janie Slash, anything else?
Thank you.
Amanda? Minx?
Thank you.
Yeah. Studying the Brutal Planet tour now.
Oh, my God. We're going
to add that one. I dare you to figure out the what is his name at the beginning? The I am the controller.
Yeah. Haven't even begun to go there. So yeah.
We never figured out. I just looked at it every day going, how does it do it? Yeah. How does it? Okay, I don't know. I don't need to know.
Yeah, it's brilliant. It really is.
But the real focus here is Beasto Blanco. We want to direct people to that website and that Facebook and look for those two releases. And as Calico said, another one probably at the end of the year. So you guys freaking rock. We love it.
Yes.
Thank you so much, man. So nice to talk to you.
Thank you, Calico. Really appreciate it.
Thank you.
All right. See you guys soon.
All right. Bye. Bye now.
Bye.
Yes. Wow, that's fantastic. I hope that Calico can come in the studio next time.
Yeah, she is super nice.
Isn't she?
Yes.
Very gracious with her time and everything. So. Yes. And you reach out to her with that.
Yeah, send her a video.
I will. I wasn't totally ready to talk. I was like,
I know, we can't throw you in here.
He will do that to me. He'll be like, you have anything else to add, Janie? And I'm like,
So we brought it out right now.
It's really hard to come up with words sometimes. You're like, she's so pretty, and she's so nice, and she's so talented. Can I just be her?
I do that to Janie Slash. So let's officially say that Amanda is here. That Amanda's here from Dallas
Amanda.
Cooper. Oh.
Yes.
Wait.
You?
What?
We're talking about you.
Oh.
Yeah.
You're right there.
Official intro. You snuck in.
Yeah. Oh, I'm supposed to say something?
Yeah, just wave.
Just say hi.
Yeah, just wave right now.
Oh, I'm just waving. Yeah. Where am I looking? I don't know.
Right there.
This is horrible.
You're on camera. Suffice to say. Yeah. So, look how pretty she is.
She's so pretty.
Oh, Amanda.
Okay. Her hair is always perfect. I have like so much stuff.
She's been rehearsing all day.
Yes.
Have you?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I saw pictures on Facebook.
They make us real. We're doing DIFA, but they make me be real hush hush about it.
Okay.
Can't talk about it.
Okay.
So,
well, tell us what do you do? You have your own dance studio, right?
Yeah, are we recording?
Yes.
Yeah,
we're live. Yeah, you're still on.
You're just talking to me.
We're live. He's talking to you.
I own my own dance studio.
And it's called?
It's called My Name, Amanda Dalton School of Dance.
Very cool.
And it's on the east side of White Rock Lake.
I want you to just get in there real friendly with it. Yeah.
Get really close up close and personal. Yeah. He yells at me about it all the time.
So it's in Dallas, near White Rock Lake.
It's in East Dallas, and it's for children, basically. I mean, I teach all ages, but basically to high school.
Yes.
Yeah.
And so a lot of it, you're channeling Calico Cooper, I'm sure, in these moves. Right.
Yeah, not with the children. Yeah, no. Well, I mean, I don't know. Some of it. I mean, Only Women Bleed is pretty classically choreographed. So, there's definitely basic technique in ballet being used. Yeah, absolutely. I'm using my training to get through that performance. It's staged, it's rehearsed, it's choreographed. It's, you know. That's
look,
why I was attracted to it, because it wasn't just some bimbo in the back, you know, half naked on stage. Which isn't wrong, but it shouldn't be me.
Right.
I like the idea of it being, we rehearse. I mean, we literally
We rehearse at her studio, and it's a workout, you know. She has flung me a few times. I had no idea how strong she was.
Talk about getting into character. Yeah.
Yeah. She grabs you by the hair and, you know, just kind of drag you right to the front of the stage.
Yeah. It's called Dancing with the Scars.
Yeah, and then there's this point where she just kind of gives you a good shove, and you're supposed to fall on your knees. And I've face planted a couple times.
Look, are we all in agreement that Calico's most gracious, coolest rock star you've ever met?
Yes, definitely.
Was she nice?
Friendly.
Oh man,
she's beautiful.
Mm-hmm. Isn't she?
And she's so cool. That's
and
so
she used to work at Cooperstown as a waitress.
That is hilarious. If you are in Arizona, though, definitely check out Cooperstown. It's really good.
And
you'll
the big beans.
There,
the big
that's
beans.
A big gate.
Now it's like, I feel like it's going to be obligatory to order the baked beans.
And go into the women's bathroom.
And go into the women's bathroom.
Order the big unit.
Big unit. Too.
I don't even eat hot dogs, but I'm going to do it. 3 feet of hot dog. You'll see pictures of it in a month, I think. Raindrops and I go
It'll take
year.
You a month to
Amanda,
eat it.
Amanda, is the dance studio only for children?
I might do some adults, but adults aren't consistent as much as children are.
Okay. Adults have a tendency to drop out of things.
Yeah, we get going. They have, you know, big ambitions, and then it fades out.
I heard that about my tarot card reading class, too. My teacher said nobody ever, there's always, like, every class he has, somebody always drops out along the way.
And you like to go out dancing, don't you?
I do.
Yeah,
sure. Dancing in general.
Yeah, just anywhere.
Yeah.
Oh, heck yeah.
Yeah, it's very therapeutic for me.
I agree.
It's tribal for me, definitely.
You know what? That's a great word. Mm-hmm. Tribal.
Yeah.
That's a word I identify with, because I'm always banging on things.
He is. I'll be like, what was that? Yeah. And he's like,
bam, bam.
That was me. That was me.
Yeah, I mean, it's just always, I think I have a Viking nature in me, a past life that was a warrior or something, or at least a drum banger. In some army somewhere. Amanda, guess what we do in this basement here? We promote extreme metal.
I've seen some of your shows.
And horror.
So it's
and
different horror. Being in here. It looks different on film.
Isn't it great, the surroundings?
It's a lot bigger than I imagined. Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, here's another movie we maybe could have mentioned in Calico.
What is that?
Gore horror.
Yeah.
That's just the greatest name ever.
Did I hear right that it's B movie she likes?
C and D movie.
Yeah.
Those are below B movies.
Right. I didn't even know there were
C and D.
That one is.
What is that, like Sleepaway Camp? What's like
that's a B movie.
Do you remember that's a B?
C and D are just.
What are the Evil Deads?
That's like an A, right? At least the first one, really good horror movies.
Yeah.
When you get to Army of Darkness and like Evil Dead 2, you get more campy, so you get more B.
I haven't watched a thousand years.
Yeah, it seems
Army of Darkness
that
is like my
sequels
favorite.
Tend to be the Bs.
But then
the more sequels you do, the lower the letter grade you're getting.
But no, like Evil Dead, there's not a single bad thing about it. Like all those movies were amazing, even the TV show. Like it's just sorry, I'm a huge Bruce Campbell fan.
No, that's totally cool.
And Sam Raimi fan.
Yeah, so we're in Dallas, and we're broadcasting from the Cool Vocal Studios, Vocal Media, and the website is vocalnow.com. So our show is live if you go to vocalnow.com Sunday evenings at 6 o'clock Central Time, but on our YouTube channel, and then we do pop them in there very quickly afterwards.
You can watch all of the past episodes. So
yeah, it'll be up right after. It's usually immediate.
I think most people go to YouTube and watch it later. You know, so if you
I think I watched it later. Yeah. I don't think I could get it streaming live one time. I was having trouble with the connection.
Okay. Yeah.
On my phone.
Gotcha. Yeah, sometimes on the phone.
Sometimes I have issues with my phone.
So we're digital radio, and I say we're the future of digital visual radio.
Oh, yeah,
so
definitely.
And you can watch us anytime on YouTube. We've got other platforms as well, and it looks like maybe some other metal radio stations along with the zoo. And we've got hip-hop as well. Coming up at vocalnow.com. So, very excited about what 2017 is bringing for this studio and for Vocal.
Yeah,
very much so.
And for Dallas.
And for Dallas Cooper.
Thank you.
And Scary Terry.
And Scary Terry.
Don't forget them.
They have a show this Friday in Houston.
That's right.
You're going to Houston.
Yes. Yeah, we're going to Houston, do a show with the Guillotines. The Guillotines are amazing.
They are.
Oh, my God. They just, my hair was flying back.
They are awesome.
So we're really looking forward to that show, Scary Cherry and the Bang Bangs. You can find us at scarycherry.com or on Facebook. Go give us a look.
And if you're in Houston, come check us out Friday.
That's right.
At Rudyard's Pub?
Rudyard's.
Rudyard's
Pub.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think Rain and I are carpooling down there.
Cool. I've got some high school friends going.
Awesome.
Yes. So you'll be on stage performing with them in Houston. Yeah. So we got two Scary Cherry people here.
Yeah.
That's right.
And Rain's going to be there, too.
Yeah. No, she's officially part of the band.
Yeah. Yeah. Cool.
Yeah. I was like, unless there's something I don't know about. I'm just kidding. You're going. I was like,
you're in the band.
I was
sorry.
Yeah, I'm going.
Hey, shout out again to one of our favorite Texas cool horror magazines called Gore Noir. Yeah. Look at that.
Great stuff.
Yeah. But the other magazine.
This is Scratch and Sniff.
The Scratch and
it's
Sniff.
It's the Tar Man.
All right, I got to smell it.
I think
it.
It's giving me allergy issues.
Yeah.
Here, you can.
Yeah. But all right, hand that over here. Let me smell this.
Okay. But look, if metal is your thing, this is the magazine you want to find. It's called Zero Tolerance, and it's based in the UK. And in my opinion, that means they have the most in depth and the coolest articles.
Yeah.
It's like, what about the hell is
that? I think it's supposed to be guts or a corpse.
Foul.
I don't
think any horror magazine should be Scratch and Sniff. Just saying. Like,
sorry, didn't mean to interrupt
That's
you there.
Right. That's okay.
There's a great article in there with interview with Piggy D, bass player of Rob Zombie. I like him. I've seen,
But I like Zero Tolerance too.
Yeah.
We find this at Barnes & Noble's and it's got a free CD with it too. And it's extreme metal and all kinds of metal. It's great metal.
You have to order Gore Noir online. Or unless you can find your loan in your local retailers. Usually they're like independent, cool, kind of gothic.
Yeah, shops. I think I'm going to need to subscribe.
Yeah, it's incredible. Their newest issue has got cover Sideshow and Circus of the Dead with Billy Pond. It's not on print yet. But
we got a couple of minutes before we bring on Leaves Eye. So we're going to play a tape. We're going to play a cassette tape. Because we're retro like that.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
We're retro. So retro.
I probably shouldn't walk over here.
No, you keep... No, let Ziggy do it. Ziggy is... Oh, we're in a karate movie. Ziggy can do it. He's got this.
Okay, so we've got our cassette player there. And I found this tape in Austin called Rotten. It's a punk band. And there's a little bit of a silent intro on the cassette tape. Is that raw, bad punk rock? I would like to see the case.
Right. What's he saying?
I can't even tell.
Sex and violence. I thought so, but I didn't want to just assume.
That is,
I should have. I like the up-tempo movement here.
Right. Yeah, we like playing cassettes sometimes. Always got to throw that in on our show. So, all right, thank you, Ziggy. He always does, you know, I should not even go near the equipment.
No,
you know,
because
something
there.
Always breaks
Ziggy's
when
got
I get
it. You can stay over there. Ziggy is almighty and powerful.
Okay, so look, guess who we're talking to now? This great band called Leaves Eyes.
I never knew.
Oh, yeah, I love
Leaves
them.
Eyes. You do? You know about them?
Yeah, of course.
Their new singer's called Elina, and that's her on the back. And this is their new EP called Fires in the North. So I think
symphonic
we'll have
metal, beautiful stuff. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And she's from Finland. I think the band is based in. Yeah. Hello. Hello. Mm. Oh, okay. So we're going to put a call in and talk to them by telephone. I think they're actually on tour and gigging tonight somewhere. So they've got a big North American tour going on, too. So, hello. Hello, Dana.
Hello.
Yes.
This is Toto from Lizais from Dana's phone.
Oh, okay. All right. All right. Good. Did you say this is Alex?
Alex is still at the dinner. I will do the interview with you and Elina.
Okay, good, good. Are we able to talk to them, or should we call back in a few? I can't quite hear you.
No, it's fine, because we anyway have to change over on stage in a few minutes, so it has to be very quick.
Okay, so is now better? Should we do it now?
Yeah,
is
now it's better.
Okay, yeah, gotcha. So it looks like we'll have Alex and Elina.
Fabulous.
Yeah. Look at her.
So it's Toto and Elina. Sorry.
Toso. Okay, I'm sorry. Toso. Gotcha.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
Yeah. Exactly, yeah.
Gotcha. Hello. Hello, Toso?
Yeah?
Yes. Hello. This is Jay from the Corpse Paint Show. Just wanted to say hello and thank you for joining us for a little bit. We have been talking about...
Thank you.
Yes, we've been talking about the new release, Fires in the North.
Yeah.
And in fact, I've got it right here in my hand. So we're excited you guys are on tour. And then I know stopping in Dallas, I think it's around May 16th or May 26th. It's later in May.
The South will be at the end of the tour, yes. Yeah.
Okay, very good. And so it's towards the end of May, I believe. And I know that the tour is with Sabaton. And we encourage our metal friends, and especially if they're into symphonic or black metal, get out to this show.
It's
going to
be awesome. It really is. I can't wait to see it. I'm so excited.
Yeah.
The club is called Trees. It's here in Dallas in Deep Ellum, and we're glad you guys are on tour again. And I know that Alina, it just looks awesome and sounds great, and she's your soprano at the front. So what a fantastic time and what a great show this should be. So. Toso, where are you playing tonight?
We are in Clifton Park. This is show number 4, and we had 3 shows so far. We played in New York. It was amazing. Like, there were more than 2,000 people.
Great.
We've been at the New England Metal Fest yesterday. It was also great. And today, Clifton Park, show number 4. So we're still at the very beginning.
Yes.
But it's already very great, because we have 2 other bands which we get along very well, and also the crew, and we're really looking forward for the rest of the tour.
Yes, this is a great tour package, and all of these bands are from Europe and from Scandinavia, so that, to me, that's the best tour.
Yeah.
Toso, and so is Elina there with you?
Yeah, of course. I'll give you Elina.
Okay.
Yeah?
All right.
So here's Elina.
Hello, Elina.
Hello. Hi, how are you?
Oh, very good. You're talking to Jay, also known as Satan, from the Corpse Paint Show. And I've got your new Fires in the North in my hand, and we're also watching the great video as well right now, too, on our screen. So you look so great, and you sound so powerful. What a soprano. And I'm sure that you're just loving it with this band now, right?
Yeah. It's been great time, you know. It's been like all over the world doing loads of shows, so yeah, it's been exciting.
We're glad you're coming back to the States, so I want to say thank you for that.
Well, that's our pleasure. Completely.
I know it's not easy to travel across that ocean and get back over here, so we really do appreciate it. So we're going to direct people definitely to Trees. That's the name of the club, and you're playing here at the end of next month with Sabaton and the third band. Are they called Beast? What are they called?
Battle Beast.
Battle Beast. It's another Beast band.
Yeah. Yeah.
Lots of Battle Beast bands.
Battle Beast. And so here's one thing, Elina. I think that if someone wanted soprano singing lessons, can they get a hold of you after the tour? Do you do lessons?
I did, actually, in New York. I had a lesson, and I have one in Tampa as well. And yes, I do teach. I live in London, so I use Skype for people who live abroad. So that works. Yeah, so absolutely. I have my website, just myname.com, so you can find elinafirala.com. So.
Very nice.
That's awesome. But, you know, my mother was an opera singer.
No kidding.
Oh, yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah.
She
sang at the Met, and she was relatively well known in her time period, but that was, you know, that was a long time ago. But.
Well, no kidding.
Oh, yeah.
That's awesome.
So, Elina, did you say you're based in New York now?
London.
We're in Clifton Park at the moment. Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry. Okay, all right. I'm sorry. For some reason, I'm just having a little trouble hearing. So, yeah, you said London, but that you're playing in New York at the moment. So.
Yes.
Thank you for talking to us, Elina. We look forward to seeing you on stage, and I hope that I get a chance to talk to you there and maybe buy you a beverage of your choice, or Toso or Alex or any of the band. You guys really, really bring a great sound, and I just love this little EP you put out with two versions of Fire in the North and the other 2016 versions. So I don't know. I think
that's awesome. Nice to hear that.
Yes, we like your band a lot, and I just can't wait to see you on stage. So,
and looking forward
awesome.
To
I'll
a
see
full
you there,
album.
Definitely, yeah.
Yeah. So I've got some people in the studio. I just want to make sure if they've got another comment or a topic to kick it out. They play some great symphonic black metal.
I've heard it. I love it.
Yes.
It's great.
Well, they'll be Fires quite happy when, as someone who's played at Trees before, the sound there is magnificent. So you'll be quite happy with the stage there.
Good.
Yeah, we actually played there on our last tour.
Oh,
so
good.
I remember that place.
Yeah.
With the trees.
With the big tree. And the one drawback, the tree in the way. Somebody always has to be behind the tree.
There's a tree on stage.
Exactly.
Yeah, there's a tree on stage, and then there's a tree, and sometimes the mosh pit gets going around, a circle around the tree, you know? So.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
When you're at Trees, you're in Deep Ellum, and I call it the entertainment capital of Texas. So I would hope that maybe you will have time to buy you a Texas taco across the street.
I hope so. I do love food, so that sounds good.
You've got to eat right to be able to sing right. That's my saying, right?
And tacos
eat well.
Are the way to go for that.
Texas tacos. Elina, thank you very much, and I hope you have a great gig tonight and the tour, and we look forward to seeing you next month.
Thank you. My pleasure. I'll see you very soon.
Leaves Eyes! The new release is Fires in the North. We love your sound. All right, we'll see you next month.
Have a good show.
See you.
All right.
Bye now.
Bye.
Bye now.
You are so weird.
I am.
And you know what?
I
like like, what the fuck is that?
I like her, and
I
like
her
this band.
Too. No, I like her too. You're just funny. You're like, let's go get a Texas taco. And
look at this.
Fuzzies, really? It's fuzzies.
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 Yeah.
Like, they're not even the best. I mean, they're okay.
Yeah, but it's convenient. That's
it's
the thing.
Torchies.
If you're at Trees, then you want to talk.
That was
about
like it. That time that someone told me Cafe Brazil was Brazilian food.
Take her to Angry Dog or something.
Yeah,
now
take
let's
her
be
somewhere,
clear.
Like take her to like Easy Sliders.
Wait,
ah,
does
there you go.
Does Trees really have a tree? And I didn't realize that. Has it always been like
there's a tree
no.
on the side?
It's
of the
really
stage.
On the side of the stage.
But somebody
yeah.
always
it's
has to be
stage.
Behind it.
Yeah.
I've never noticed that. I mean, I thought there was like on the ceiling made to look like painted leaves, but right at
yeah,
one time.
Yeah.
One
time.
I think.
I haven't been to Trees in like a decade.
Yeah, it was always the bass player that got stuck behind
this tree.
Yeah,
the big pole on
well,
stage.
You remember that one time we went to go see the Pizza Underground and Macaulay Culkin was stuck behind the tree and the girls kept coming up and like trying to climb on stage and were like Macaulay and I like tried to ram them in the tree to get them to go away.
Wait, he was singing? He's in a band?
No, he plays kazoo.
The Pizza Underground, it's called. Yeah.
We gave out free pizza. It was worth it.
They gave out pizza at the gig.
It wasn't even bad. That's the bad part. That's the part. Cool. I don't know. I enjoyed it, actually.
So let's be clear.
The drummer plays pizza box.
Elina is the new singer of Lee's Eyes.
Yes.
And she's fantastic. And she really
she
brings
is.
It.
Yeah.
And so you know someone is good when they teach it. She also teaches voice, singing, soprano
it's not
lessons.
It's easy. I'm
to,
sure. I mean, I don't
to
have
anyone who would like
it. It doesn't look easy.
So, Amanda, if you wanted to be a powerhouse singer in that vein,
go to London.
She will Skype right. with you.
Or oh, she'll Skype. Skype. Yeah.
She'll Skype
yeah.
with you.
You don't want me to sing. No. No. I'll just stick to moving my body.
Like you don't want me to dance.
Right. I'll just stick to what I know. No, you're a good dancer.
Oh, God.
You're easy to work with.
I'm one of those jerky dancers, you know?
No, you're not.
Yeah.
I've never seen Minx dance, so I can't.
It's, yeah.
I've only seen him play guitar.
You're not missing anything, that's for sure.
Oh, come on.
Yeah. I mean, I enjoy dancing. That's the sad part, is that I enjoy it so much, you know? And I remember I had a roommate one time who just did this. She just stood. The first time, she was, you know, female roommate. We went out together, and she said, you know, come on, we're all going dancing. I'm like, all right, I'll go with you guys. And they were all, like, 10 years younger than me, right? And we went to this club. And they just stopped and just were, like, watching me. And I felt like that Seinfeld moment, you know?
Oh, come on.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. No, they were like, what are you doing?
So your mother was a professional opera singer, but your father, his father was a professional ballet dancer.
Yeah.
Instructor.
Yeah,
I know.
He was the shit, for real.
You got a lot of talent, man, in your genes, don't you?
Yeah.
That's great.
That talent did not get passed down to me.
Oh,
the dancing talent. But yeah, no, he was the... amazing dancer, and he danced with the Ballet Russe de Monte Carlo, which, you know, is, you know, historically one of the most famous, you know, ballet companies.
I stalked him online when you told me that. I was like, hold on.
Who?
Stalking his dad.
Cool.
Yeah, pretty cool. So I grew up in a very musical environment, you know, but it... And my poor dad, he put up with so much. He really did. Because, you know, he's the guy that would wake up to the classical station, and it was always like the piano concertos in the morning. It was very soft. And then, you know, I don't know what would be coming out of my room, Black Sabbath or something, you know. Or Sex Pistols. And he would come in and go, what are you listening to there, you know? It's a Clash, Dad.
Yeah.
Well, it's very interesting, very interesting. And he always encouraged me, you know. He really encouraged me. You know, he let me convert our garage into a rehearsal room, and I put all those egg crates up everywhere,
yeah.
You know, and did that sort of thing. So, and we played at ridiculous levels. We were so loud that literally... one time, like, mice came out of the walls and scattered when we started playing. We had no idea that we were that loud. I'm surprised.
Mice came out of the walls.
That could have been like
scattered.
A new business. You could have been exterminator.
Exterminator.
We will come rock your rats out of your house.
Exactly. Yeah. No. And it was we had no idea that we even had rodents. You know, they just emerged after, you know, 120 decibels of Marshall amplification.
And now on stage, the exterminators.
Exactly. That should have went for that name. You know?
I always think it's interesting to grow up in a home where your mother and your father support the arts. I mean, that's kind of like Calico. I mean, she grew up backstage.
Yeah.
So it was just a natural progression in comparison to an artist that grows up in a home that's not understood or supported.
Yeah.
So I always think that's interesting.
Good
that
point.
Your family was not only supportive, but you were living amongst them, you know, I mean, other artists where, you know, my mother and father had... You know, so we're supportive, but difficulty in understanding, I think, the obsession you can get with your art form.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
And, you know, your tunnel vision with it.
And converting the garage.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. Like, to be able to do that, like, I would have given anything to have my father say, let's convert the garage to a space for you to make art, whatever that is. So.
And he didn't say turn off the Clash. He said the Clash are interesting.
Yeah, he's interested. Yeah.
Yeah. So. Yeah. He always, the one thing he had a hard time doing is, you know, one time I was watching, I don't know, so I can't remember what, watching a video, and he just had a hard time relating to, like, the nonstop, you know, like, flashes of, there, to him, there was nothing cohesive, like, he was trying to watch a rock video, and didn't understand like all of the
fast editing.
Yeah,
he's trying to watch the lines and the choreography. He just doesn't understand that.
Yeah,
that
was rough for him. Yeah.
And there wasn't a flow. It was instead chops.
But it's always interesting, you know. I mean, I would love to have, you know, ask Calico more about her childhood. I mean, I don't know what that's to have grown up in. I mean, did she even want to pursue? Or was it something that just happens because that's...
Because she was on tour.
Because that's all you know.
Yeah. Right. She did 11 tours with him, too.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
That's amazing.
Well, you know, Sting's daughter has a new album out, and it's not metal or anything like that, but we saw her do a free tour here in town, and she was on a beat-up bus with these five guys paying her dues. I mean, this is Sting's daughter. Yeah. I mean, you would have thought she would have had a little bit of nicer, you know, digs, but I'm sure he said to her... Get out there
and pay your dues.
But just that support system of knowing what the dues are, I think that's the hardest thing. You know, you putting the dues in, and you know, people want things so instant now.
Oh yeah.
That time has kind of changed, I think, for artists. You know.
Well, she did say earlier that she did work at the restaurant when she was a teenager, and she did have to pay her dues and pay her bills, and then she got into the band.
She sold retail. She had to go out and get a job like
everybody. She wasn't even an original member of the band. They just happened to hear her goofing off and being silly and singing, and said, "Hey, come in here and do this."
Yeah, it's interesting because they're, you know, roughing it and paying their dues, but they probably have the best bass player, you know, the industry can give you. You know, when you're 19. You know, yeah, honey, go rough it, but here's the best, you know, bass player ever.
Right. Good point. That's a good point. But, you know, we in America for a while there, it seemed like to become famous, you just had to do well on on The Voice or whatever.
Or
right?
YouTube.
And suddenly you're big. But
just YouTube, seriously.
But isn't that the problem? People want to be famous
problem.
Instead of make the art? I mean, you're made famous through your art, not...
It's paying the dues, like you said, and traveling in that old beat-up van for years to pay your dues along the way is really how you define and achieve success.
Yeah. But it's different now.
Social media is shit all over that.
Yeah.
You know? But, I mean, there are people still out there doing it, and those are the people I respect. But, you know, to be famous for the sake of...
That's right. That's why we go support bands that come into town that are from across the pond.
Absolutely. Yeah.
And also local bands. The smaller bands, you need to go out and support them.
I think a lot of people don't realize how much it costs also to put a band like this on tour. It's ridiculous sums of money. I mean, Scary Cherry did a 6.5-week tour of the United States. And 6.5 weeks is a long time to get out on the road for a band of our level. And it cost so much money. It was ridiculous. I mean, we were so lucky to break even. Which is what we did. We came back, we broke even, which is almost unheard of for a first-time headline tour. But
you were almost expecting to lose money. You
we thoroughly expected. We calculated that we would lose at least about $15,000.
Well, it's advertisement.
Yeah.
I mean, it's
Yeah.
You just go into it knowing you're going to lose that, but you're going to hopefully gain.
Yeah.
More.
Yeah, we were really lucky, but it was really costly. Yeah, and tiring.
I mean,
you know, the first couple weeks on the road, you know, we were like, yeah. After a while, I'm like, you know what, you stink.
But then the last week, you know, it's ending, and so you're just like trying to squeeze it all you can.
Yeah, you know, when we were in the home stretch, you know, you're just part of you is dying just to get home, and the other part is just breaking down sad because it's ending, you know.
Oh, it's sad. Yeah. You get the relationships that you build on tour with your band or your or whatever theater production you're in is intense. And I've worked with people for short weeks and then haven't seen them for a decade, and they're like, still, you feel such a connection to them when you work so intimately.
And another thing I would have liked to have asked Calico, kind of like you were saying, is
next
that
time.
Next time,
Well, that's when we're Facebook friends. We'll just, you know, that's when I go visit her. And that's when she needs me to stand in for her in one of the shows.
Right.
You know, just stuff like that.
Yeah, that could happen.
I'm just throwing it out there.
Because you got it down. We're throwing it out there, Calico.
Hey,
just
you know,
keep it in mind.
Throwing it to the universe, you never know.
Just throw it out there, right. Throw
it usually
to the
comes back to you.
So what were you going to ask?
Is that, you know, when she's playing in front of 20,000 people in Germany, like she was, you know, and then she said it was all adrenaline and she's superhuman. You know, what is it like? And maybe you guys can answer that. I mean, at the end of that show that night.
Depressing.
It's depressing.
You
from being a hero for of 20,000, 25,000 people to being alone in your hotel.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What is that like?
Yeah. No. I mean, just like Amanda was just saying, that night you're still kind of high on.
Oh, you're high, definitely.
You know, the next day, and then, you know, and the worst is, you know, like when you go about a week later, and then it's just, you know.
Or if there's nothing on the books.
Right, yeah. No shows booked, and you're just waiting. Oh, yeah.
Being a performer, you kind of weigh your success by what you have on the books. I mean, I know. Like, if I don't have any shows booked, I'm like, I suck. I'm the worst performer ever. I just should quit. Right.
Well, speaking of that, Janie Slash, of course, produces Deadly Sins Burlesque and Sideshow.
Yeah.
And Sideshow, yeah.
Yeah.
So, next show is?
May 13th.
That's a Saturday.
It's the second Saturday in May. Mm-hmm.
At Wits End.
Yes.
In Deep Ellum, the entertainment capital of Texas, in the heart of Dallas.
Yeah, I hate missing those. So, I'll be there.
It's going to be a good
one. Well, good. Yeah, so that's the May show. It is going to be a good one.
Yeah, they're all good, though.
Because you've got a lot of extreme things.
I have a lot of really great performers. Yeah. That is for sure.
We saw the pictures of Scarlett earlier.
Scarlett's incredible. Everybody's incredible.
We've had Bijou in
that
chair.
Bijou will be back.
In that chair right
Bijou
there.
Bijou will be back this month. She was gone last month. And then we'll have Luna Bay back. Everybody loved her, so...
Bijou was out doing something for somebody else.
She did the Dallas and Houston Burlesque Festivals.
Yeah, that's the one. Yeah.
Yeah, so she took a couple months off, but she's back.
Yeah,
doing spankings at intermission. So if anyone wants to be spanked,
you know Bam Bam.
You got to sacrifice Bam Bam.
Bang Bang. Well, he's always like the first volunteer, you know.
Yeah. We have a message on the show, and that is
he is a great volunteer, also. For his Bam Bam. Ass spanking,
And that is, you find your creative desire, you find what your purpose is in life, and you follow it. You make a step in that direction every day. That's what this show is about. Find your life's purpose and pay your dues to get there and do what it takes, but make a step every day in that direction. So more than anything, that's what we want to say on this show, and just follow it. The time will be right. And the time is usually now to begin. So action steps in the direction you want to go. That's what we're all about.
Yep.
Hey, so you four people in this room, renew my faith in humanity. You do. Thank you for being awesome and positive and uplifting and creative.
Thank you.
And writing great
for having
songs.
Us on.
And performing and dancing and helping children. How hard is that? My gosh, Janie Slash pounds things into her head. Ziggy
and
handles
Ziggy.
A huge board and audio and video and a lot of camera work. And no other show demands that of him. We do. Yeah. And hails to Ziggy. So thank you.
Every time I think of Bowie, Ziggy. I think of him now.
Yeah, Ziggy. Right. But so I love you guys. Thank you very much, man, for supporting the Corpse Paint Show.
We love this show.
Yeah, good. Great show. Yeah.
Thanks, man. Well, let's get the word out for it. So. We want to bring exposure to the unusual, the underground, the creative, the wild, and the extreme. We do.
Yeah.
And I like it when we have a great guest like Calico. When we have Amanda come in the studio, thank you.
Thank you, Amanda. Thanks for having me.
Yes. She teaches children.
To dance.
That's right.
How hard is that?
And having Leaves it's Eyes hard. On the radio.
And Leaves that, Eyes. We're playing Leaves Eyes, man.
I wasn't expecting that. That's amazing. Yeah.
We like them.
They're heroes.
Janie Slash, you inspire me. Aww. Thank you. You worked hard, and she did slime wrestling and everything.
I did, and I won.
She beat a cyborg.
Voodoo Magic Designs helps us so much. We're going to do an outro that they created. And Ziggy, big hails and thanks to you, man, as usual. Yes. Thank you, Ziggy.
And have a good week.
So, we're back next week. A lot of wildness. Yes.
We'll be listening.
Good night.